So far. Fantastic. But people sometimes say to me, would you recommend songwriting as a vocation? And I say to them, well, listen, Down Under took 40 minutes to write, and it's kept me for 40 years so far. Yes. I highly recommend it. But you never know. I walk around with I walk around the streets back in Los Angeles. They're pretty anonymous, you know, and nobody bothers me, and it's great. It's very nice. But like 40 years ago, when I first came to the United States with the old band, it was different, you know. First time I ever flew into New York, it was in a helicopter, and everyone knew my name. It was the most bizarre thing, you know. Just imagine when you're walking down the street. First of all, it's very exciting looking in New York anyway. But if I went there and I had a number one record, so people were like, cab drivers would open the window and go past, but now you don't, Carl, now you don't. People just, you know, people would talk to you, you know, oh, God. Hundreds of them, thousands of them. And now, I got nothing. Which is good. Because you go to the shops and you get your slippers on and the track pants and the t-shirt you fucking slept in and a stupid old hat and you think, oh, I'm glad people don't recognize you. So it's good for the most part. Except occasionally when I'm in the line at CVS and there's six people in front of me and one of my songs is playing through the sound system. Sometimes I just want to say, hey! Don't you people realize I'm a Grammy-winning, multi-platinum selling, fucking hit-making pop sensation from the 80s? From the 80s, what's that? Oh yeah, 6/29/1954. Thank you very much. That's just for two things, isn't it? And we had climate change nailed, except for those fucking receipts at CVS. A tree in one of those receipts. Should go,
yeah,
if you get a chance,
because
it's truly awesome. When I first arrived there, I would turn up at get driven down to the surf with one of your friends, you know, drive for an hour and a half or something out of the city. And you would just walk through the sand in between this corridor of tea tree. And the sulfur-crested cockatoos were screeching overhead. And you could hear the magpies in the bush whistling their tune. And the sand wasn't really that hot yet because it was still early in the morning. You come to the sand dunes. You walk over the sand dunes. And there it was, right in front of you. The mighty Pacific. remember thinking, oh, this is my new home. Traveling in a fly-like combi, a hippie trailhead full of zombies. I met a strange lady, she made me nervous. She took me in and gave me breakfast. She said, you come from a land down under. Women blow and men plunder. Can't you hear the thunder? You better run, you better take cover. Take